and have to get on this plane. It's our best friend's wedding tomorrow.
We made such a fuss, but you weren't getting married without your bridesmaids.
So? Where is he then? Where's Kai? We're dying to meet him.
How's your mom? I bet Donna's going nuts over this wedding.
I've been dying for you to get here. I've got a secret. You're the only ones I can tell.
Oh my god, you're pregnant?
No. I've invited my dad to the wedding.
You're dead.
You mean you finally found him?
Not exactly. Look, I found this in mom's desk.
Sophie, you're not supposed to go reading your mom's diary.
No, she's supposed to go around reading yours.
But look, 1979. Someone should get the year she got pregnant with me. You know how she won't talk about my dad? She says she can't remember. But listen, July 17th. What a night. After the show, Sam rode me over to the little island. We danced on the beach and kissed on the beach and dot, dot, dot.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. That's what they did in the olden days. Sam's the one. I know he is. I've never felt like this before.
I'm trying to see.
show for limiting at Water's Edge?
Yes. Mama knows I don't do walking.
Well, will you look at what the tag was then?
Of you.
God, Tanya, 8 friggin' years.
I know, honey, I'm sorry. It's just been one jet-setting millionaire after another.
I know. I've been taking this place, the constant battle with the bank manager.
Hi, Vinny, the poor bank manager.
Andy Rosie! Sophie Sheridan, you look more gorgeous every time I see you. Don't even think that how you come up with
me. I bet you don't remember me.
All that plastic surgery. Tanya? Oh, you look at my baby, a whole life ahead of her. Mom, I'm getting married, not joining a convent.
I know. Well, in my day, they just get married at 20.
Dawn and Artie, we didn't get married, period.
A white wedding. Can you believe this? I don't know where she gets it from.
Don't blame me, Dawn. It wasn't my idea.
Girl, we've been leading men at tomorrow's shindig. Sky, this is Tanya and Rosie, my one-time backup band and all-time best pals. Backup band, my ass.
Hello. I've heard lots of messages.
Oh, that I hope.
Yasukuka Moo.
Woo!
That's
hey.
Don't bother. She doesn't speak Greek. My name's Eddie. Bonjour, madam.
Bonjour, Eddie. Enchanté de vous recevoir.
Bon appétit.
And they call me Pep.
Why? Because you're hot?
Because it gets under your nose.
Tanya, meet Pepper and Eddie Mine. Bar staff, boatsmen, waiters, and general help. Only the generally know help. Don't you have any work to do?
Honey, the taverna looks fabulous.
You've got Sky to thank for that.
Why? What have you been up to?
You haven't been here in that long, have you?
Oh, I took a break from stocks and bonds and back.
Why?
I had enough. I have been feeling this world, but I never.
Well, you should see what he's done to my world. He's got me all my email wired up and knuckled down. You just invent me a machine that'll make the beds.
If they did, you'd be going around behind it making them again.
I know you, Mom. Are you kidding? I'll be more than ready to put my feet up when my boat comes in.
Speaking of boats, I think that old wreck got moored by the jetties.
Sink it?
It's a bit of an eyesore.
That eyesore's looking for my floating casino.
What?
Sky and Eddie are transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Sailing around the island, gambling under the stars.
Gambling millionaires. Maybe it's your ex-husband's blood, Tanya.
I don't think so, honey. I spent their millions.
Well, girls, that's my jackpot. I need a break. I need a vacation. I've been running this whole thing for 15 years, and I've never had a day off. I work all night.
I wouldn't have to work at all and fool around and have a ball.
That was nothing. Did you try kayaking the Okavango swamps?
Yes, I read your book, A Bloke in a Boat, Botswana.
Thanks, Harry. I heard I sold a copy somewhere.
Well, travel books are my passion. A distraction from the daily rigors of a London rush hour.
You two want to hear something interesting? You see this tomato?
I'm rather impressed. I remember an old hut here. Ready for any down to goats.
Give me goats before camels. There was this time in the Kalahari. The sun was beating down.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt, Indiana. But the point is, this is my Timberland. I built it. Well, I designed it. I drew the plans, 21 years ago? Can't believe she's actually gone and built the damn thing.
Who?
Donna. Who else? It's something I scribbled on the back of a menu. I had no idea.
How do you know it's yours?
Buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
I wouldn't know about babies. I've been living out of the backpack all my life.
The happy wonder, right? Do you think the honor will inspire some prose?
I hope so. When I got the wedding invite, I sold my editor a piece on Childhood Haunts Revisited.
Were you born here?
I was born in the U.S., but my mother's Greek. No, the only time I came to Greece was to visit with my great-aunt on the mainland, and that was 21 years ago?
So, now you can write about Sam Savona and the Trolls of Flock.
No, I think this island should remain the secret idol I've always remembered.
Maybe if you lived here, the island would be the boatload of tourists, the big bus.
Well, at least they might have some stuff then. Where is everybody?
Good afternoon. Can I help you?
Hi, I'm Bill Austin. You have a room for me?
Bill Austin?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry? So you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You're expecting us.
Oh, yes. I'll go and I'll get the keys.
Charming. But I hope I get the chance to get my tongue around a little Greek. I haven't spoken it for 21 years.
21 years? You know, this is beginning to feel like a setup. Hey, Bill, here's a story for you. Three men, strangers, are invited to a wedding. They're invited to a place they haven't seen for 21 years by a woman they haven't seen for 21 years. Why are they here?
That's not bad. Okay, Harry, Bill, let's turn you away from the Bank of England.
What is this, an interview? All right. Well, for me, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories. Bloody Nora!
Is that a quote?
No, I know this guitar. HB, headbanger. That's what they used to call me in those days. And DS, Donna Sheridan. I bought this for her. $10 in my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. And who says I'm an unadventurous old stick in the mud?
Who?
My other half. A big house, fast car, and a season ticket to Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, isn't it? Well, they want the Great White Hunter too. Well, I can do spontaneity. That's why I'm here. Don't undo my wild side. I was an exchange student in Paris when we first met, and I just followed to Greece spontaneously. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Please sing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
You're Donna's daughter.
Sophie, Sophia.
It's just Sophie.
No, Sophia's the Greek. I had a great aunt, Sophie.
My name's after Sophia.
Where's Donna? I'd like to see her. Thank her for the invitation.
Yes, it's very kind of her to remember us.
Oh, you can't. I send invitations. Mom doesn't know.
For what?
Oh, Mom's always talking about her friends in like good old days, and I thought she'd be thrilled if I invited you all. But she's got herself in such a state about this wedding that she's not expecting guests. She'll
hyperventilate. Sophie, hold on, are you trying to tell me Donna didn't invite me?
No, she didn't, so pretending for a holiday. If she sees you at my wedding, she'll get a lovely surprise, and then we can let her in on the secret.
But Sophie...
Mother says I'm going to dance before I get along.
What have you made a mistake?
I often wonder, how did it all start? We found out that
friends, but the last time your mother saw me, she said she never wanted to see me again. So if you're the one who sent those invitations, I'm afraid I'm still banned.
But that was years ago. I want you here.
Why?
Because it's my wedding, and I want us all to be friends.
You're just a little mix. You're worse than your mother. Glad you haven't met my boys.
Your boys? You have sons?
Yeah, I've got two. I want to bring them here someday.
Like you used to bring my mother?
Pinch you?
You can't keep your hands to yourself.
Change your tune.
What the hell are you doing, Sam?
What the hell are any of you doing here? I'm sorry. I'm amazed to see you all.
Well, I'm doing a piece for a magazine.
And I'm here for a holiday.
I thought I'd just drop in and say hi.
Oh dear, what a shame. We got no rooms. It's that time of year.
Just as well I booked ahead. You two can bunk down with me if they're really full.
This is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because one of the local girls is getting married tomorrow and I don't have the staff to call with you. You'd be much more comfortable on the mainland.
Not at all. Bill's used to suffering for his art. And headbanger here is the last word in spontaneous.
What about you?
I came to see the island. You know what it meant to me.
Well, I'd love to stop and stroll over all times, but I have to go and clean out my purse.
I was expecting to smoke into the housewife.
No, she's still done.
Just one look and I can hear a bell ring. One more look and I forget everything. Whoa!
time to tell you the truth.
Friday night at the
guys haven't sold me a flat dance with people at the bar. I'm undressing. Everyone's gonna bring the same stuff.
Don't go.
What? You haven't sit on my last night of freedom.
No, I don't mean don't go. I mean, is that really how you see it?
Yeah. No. I see it as the last night before the biggest adventure of my life.
You know how I said I wanted to find my dad?
I've spoken over this 1,000 times. It's your dad. It's your family.
Yes. Oh, Sky, whatever happens, you'll never leave me, will you?
Crazy? You turn my world upside down.
I love you, Dad.
Thank you.
No, I'm glad you did. This is such a quiet little island.
Regretting staying away so long?
No, regretting I never knew it was here.
What?
This place, the Taverna. I always wanted to come back and build it someday, but Donna, she keeps doing it.
Do you always prefer buildings to people?
What?
Tell me something about my mom.
Your mom was irresistible, one of a kind. We talked and we fought, and did you know it's me that brought her to this island?
That wasn't the only thing you did, that was it.
What has she told you?
Nothing. She's never mentioned you before.
But you said mom's always talking about her friends from the old days. What's going on, Sophie? Why am I here?
You've got to talk to her.
This has got nothing to do with her. All my life has been one big unanswered question, and I'm tired of the secrecy.
But Sophie, this hasn't been my secret. Thank you. I think so.
What comes next?
Don't tell me you've got a twin sister.
No. Will you give me away tomorrow?
Give you away?
I'll feel like a proper bride when I'm walking down the aisle with my father.
Sophie, the boys are back.
I'll go find your mother.
No, not tonight. Please wait until the wedding.
You're going crazy.
Thank you.
Jesse, what's going on? What are you doing? It's 6 o'clock in the morning.
I don't know.
But wait right there.
I'm all right, Mom.
Of course you're not all right. You're sleepwalking again.
Again? When do I ever sleepwalk?
The night you came down with the measles, the time you couldn't finish your times tables.
Oh, Mom, get off. I'm not a baby.
I know, but you're still my daughter, so, and I know that something's wrong.
It can be stopped.
It isn't too late. I can sort out these wedding shenanigans.
Shenanigans? What do you mean, shenanigans?
I'm sorry, it's just a figure of speech.
No, that's what you think, isn't it? I'm stupid to get married. It's just a wedding.
Well, I'm not pretending I really know, but...
Of course you don't. You did just fine without a man. You never did that whole marriage and baby thing. You just did the baby.
What the hell is this about? Why are you coming down on me?
I'm going to do it right, Mom. I love Skye, and I want to be with him. And I don't want my children growing up not knowing who their father is because it's crap.
Jesus, would you stop that racket before you wake the entire island? Eddie, where did you get that monstrosity?
Oh, he's not so bad.
Hey.
No, I found these babies in the cellar. Just for the wedding. Are they yours, Donna?
No, they're... And what sort of wedding do you think that there's going to be in the state of the three of you? Skye, you're not marrying my daughter smelling like a frat house. Hit the tub. And where do you think you're going?
To scrub the groom's back?
No, you're not. I want the champagne on ice, the ouzo and the punch bowls, like the tablecloths and the cutlery and the best glasses, and you'll have to wash and polish them first. Eddie, get your boat out.
Why?
Because my guests want to go dive down to the old wreck to look for more green necklaces.
Donna, we planned for the one Skye found last night.
I don't care. It'll keep the guests busy until the wedding starts. For God's sake, just do it.
Well, can you take a look at that roof? It won't last through the winter.
I'll fix my own damn roof.
Okay, fine. Be a martyr. I've got kids. I know it's hard for you doing it on your own.
Don't you patronize me. I love doing it on my own. Every morning I wake up and I thank Christ I have some middle-aged menopausal man to bother me. I'm single. I'm free. And it's great.
Where are those happy days? They seem so hard to find. I tried to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. Whatever happened to our love? I wish I understood. Used to be so nice, it used to be so good.
Signora, this should tickle your taste buds.
Yes, but will it cure my hangover?
You should look in the mirror, baby. You just cured mine.
Dapper boy, I'm old enough to be your mother.
Well then, you can call me Oedipus.
Oh? Harry!
What time is it? Shouldn't you be getting ready?
Oh, don't worry about me, Harry. I've got loads of time. There's nothing worse than sitting in your pantyhose for hours.
Well, Donna must be tearing her hair out during the wedding on her own. What would the bride's father usually do?
Well, he'd usually pay. But my father drew the line at my third.
Did he say anything beforehand? Any words of advice, that sort of thing?
Yes. There I'd be in my cupcake dress, all ready to trip down the aisle, and he'd whisper, "Don't worry, doll. I know a good lawyer." Now why are we talking about my dad?
I think I'll go back to my room. Too much stuff.
No, Harry, don't go.
Let's catch up tonight. Tanya! Why don't we catch up from last night?
I've drawn a veil over last night. Last night never happened.
Pepper! Chop chop! Chicken cocktails all around.
There's the bar. Help yourself.
You have to do it. We're guests now.
Just can't find some help these days.
Is that all you caught? You should have seen the one that got away.
This big.
Oh, Phil. Oh, Fontaine.
It was this big!
You want a drink?
Thanks, but no thanks. She's promised me the worst.
I have?
You know, I always keep your whole woman cookbook in my backpack.
You do? Who wanted to know how to pepper my snapper? Come on,
look at the time. Come on, girls, you've got work to do.
Work?
On my face, sweetie, a little repair and renovation.
You don't mess with a masterpiece.
He is so tragic.
All in, no service.
Don't be a jerk.
Tanya cannot ignore the chemistry between us.
Little boys who play with fire get their fingers burned.
Ow!
Donna's going crazy.
Sky,
bad luck to see each other before the wedding.
Don't come out of the place. Okay, look, you've got to help me.
Why? What's happened?
It's all a mess and it's all my fault. I know I shouldn't have, but I read my mom's diary. I've got 3 possible dads.
Oh my god.
I invited them to the wedding. I thought I'd know which one of them it was as soon as I saw him, but I didn't. And now all 3 think they're my dad, and they're all expecting to give me away.
Wait, back up a minute. You did what?
I invited them to the wedding. It was 3 months ago. I didn't think they'd come.
3 months? Why didn't you tell me?
I knew you would like it.
I thought we had trust. I thought we talked about everything. Did you run behind my back for some stranger?
No, it wasn't like that.
Is this what the big white wedding's for? A setup so you can find your dad?
No, it's not that at all.
I wanted to go to the mainland and get married with a couple of them. Instead, you insisted on this fantasy wedding just to play happy families.
It's about knowing who I am. I want to get married knowing who I am.
It doesn't come from knowing who your dad is, Sophie. It comes from knowing who you are. How would you feel if I lied to you? I was marrying you because I thought I loved you, but now I'm not so sure.
Sorry, I'm interrupting.
No. It's
fine.
Think about this.
No, Stan, wait.
What's going on?
Nothing. Excuse me.
Let him go. He's right. You have to be sure this is what you really want.
This has got nothing to do with you.
I'm your father, Sophie. I can't give you away unless I know you're really happy.
I've had this conversation before with my mother, and I think she knows me a lot better than you do.
What does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage? Or divorce? Listen, I've got 20 years of good advice to cram into 2 minutes, so hear me out. You're so young. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Not now, Sam, please.
But I've been there. I've done the big white wedding and the cake, and I'm sorry, it doesn't always turn out happy ever after. I can still remember pleading with my wife. Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I have to go. Knowing me, knowing you, it's the best I can do.
Have to face it, this time we're through. Breaking up is
can't get my hat right.
Yes.
I can't get anything right. Come in.
Donna.
Harry, what are you doing here?
I wanted you to have this.
Call me here. I mean on this island.
Please.
Holy shit, what is this?
Well, I thought you might have had to tighten your belt a bit over the years, looking after Sophie on your own, so I wanted to contribute a little something to the wedding.
This would cover 4 weddings and a funeral. Harry, I can't take this. I need it.
Do you remember the last time you said that to me?
No.
The night I bought you the guitar. I remember thinking, those are the last words I'll ever hear from them, and I'll always treasure them. Oh, Harry, lovely gesture. But
you just made that up. I'm sure I said thank you nicely, like a little proud Catholic girl.
That's better. You know, that's the first time I've seen you laugh since I've arrived.
What do you expect, Harry? I'm a bit stressed out.
Well, a bit more of the old Donna, a bit less of the well-brought-up Catholic.
Is an absent mind.
Dad.
Why in the world did you say that?
Oh, well, my friends would say, your mom's so cool running a business and bringing up a kid all on her own.
Well, I didn't have much of a choice, did I?
My married mom was 77. I couldn't very well go back home. My mother disowned me.
Building a fence.
I got this note from Sophie. She wanted me to give her away, but now she's changed her mind. I'm confused. I don't know where I am. I don't know who I am. I just came here for a wedding. I'm Sophie's dad.
Whoa. You need to have a conversation with Donna.
Yeah, I'll go tell her now.
You do no such thing. Sophie's getting married in 5 minutes. Take a pew and button it.
Will it be alright for me to be here?
Oh, for goodness sake.
Well, to tell you the truth, I was dreading to walk down the aisle. I may come across as an intrepid traveler, but I come over all faint at the thought of a wedding.
Oh, tell me.
Marriage, children, responsibility. I'm a writer. I made up my mind long ago. I walk a lone path.
You changed your mind. I'm the first in line. I am still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Don't be alright. You've got no place to go, you ain't down. If you're all alone, when you put your hand first, I'll come and I'll stand.
Especially welcome to Donna, who represents your family. You're really beloved. We are glad
you're. And welcome to Sophie's dad. What? I can't keep it from you any longer. I have to tell you he's here. I know. What? I invented it, but you couldn't have. I don't know which one of them it is. Oh my God, that's why they're all here.
I'm really, really sorry, Mom. Will you ever be able to forgive me?
Will you ever forgive me?
I don't care if I suffered hundreds of men.
Oh, so. And I haven't slept hundreds of men.
Hold on. Am I getting this right? Sophie might be mine, but she might be Bill's or Harry's?
Yes, that's right. And don't you go getting all self-righteous on me. You've only got yourself to blame.
What?
If you hadn't dumped my mom and gone off to marry some other woman...
It wasn't like that. I was engaged. I had to go home. But I came right back.
What?
I told Lorraine I couldn't marry her and I came right back.
Why didn't you call me?
Because I was stupid enough to think you'd be sitting in your room pining for me. When I arrived, they told me you were off with some other guy. I went straight back home. Rachel told me what an idiot I was, and married me to prove it.
I'm sorry. If I might just cut in for a moment.
Oh, Harry, the check, of course.
No, stop the check. It's yours. Donna, you were the first girl I ever loved. And you were also the last girl I ever loved. Look, there's all kinds of families, aren't there? Yours is you and Sophie, and mine is me and I. It's great to have a third of Sophie. I never even thought I'd get that much of a daughter.
I agree with Harry. Being a third of your dad is great by me.
Me too.
Isn't it crazy? Wait, 21 years of your dad and 3 years at the same time?
Well, we could find out which one is my father, but I don't need to. I don't care. I've learned something about myself. Sky, let's not get married.
What?
I know you never wanted all this, and I've got my whole life ahead of me. Just get off the side of me and get at that world.
Donna, I take it the wedding's canceled?
Oh, I haven't got a clue what's going on.
Hold on. Why should we waste a good wedding? About a Donna, you're gonna need someone to order it on this island of yours.
Are you nuts? I am not a bigamist.
Neither am I. I'm a divorced man who's loved you for 21 years. And ever since I got on this island, I've been bursting to show you how much. Come on, Donna, tell me the rest of your life.
Thank you.
Imagine if you just yell, have my kids.